An incidental renal mass was detected on ultrasound. So first of all, this is an ultrasound image where this is the kidney, and we see that in the kidney there is this well-defined hyperechoic, that is white mass. This is uniformly hyperechoic or echogenic. So that is fat. Fat is hyperechoic on ultrasound. So this is a fat containing lesion in the kidney, most common angiomyolipoma. So the angiomyolipoma will have blood vessels, that is angio, it will have muscles, myo, and it will have fat, that is lipoma. So if we do a CT scan, in the CT scan, this is the right kidney and that's the left kidney. In the right kidney, we see this mass here, which has black areas. So black on CT is either air or fat. It is dirty black, so it is fat, because it is lipoma, angiomyolipoma. So we know that fat is black because it has negative HU value on CT scan. So this is a correct statement that angiomyolipoma will have negative HU value. It is associated with Sturge-Weber is incorrect because it is associated with tuberous sclerosis and in some cases with neurofibromatosis and von Hippel-Lindau syndrome, but most common tuberous sclerosis. If a renal angiomyolipoma is large enough, more than 4 cm, it can bleed and cause shock in a patient, which becomes an emergency, and it needs to be treated with embolization. So the risk of hemorrhage depends not on location but on size of the lesion, more than 4 cm. On angiography, it has an onion peel or whorled appearance because of the myo component. Just like myoma or fibroid in the uterus, which has a whorled appearance, even angiomyolipoma has onion peel or whorled appearance on angiography. To summarize renal angiomyolipoma, it's a benign lesion. 80% of the times it is sporadic and incidentally found, in which it is a solitary lesion. 20% it is associated with tuberous sclerosis, and in that case it is multiple and bilateral. Incidental finding of bilateral multiple renal angiomyolipoma may be the only sign of tuberous sclerosis in some patients. So since it is angiomyolipoma, it will have blood vessel, muscle and fat. So because of the fat content, on ultrasound it will be hyperechoic. On CT scan, it will have negative HU value, approximately minus 100. On MRI, we know that fat is white on both T1 and T2. So it will be hyperintense. And on fat suppressed images, the fat component gets suppressed, so it will be dark. When we do in-phase and out-phase MRI, which is done for fat containing lesions, fat is identified by India ink artifact or chemical shift artifact. So because of the fat component, it will give India ink artifact. The risk of hemorrhage depends on size. More than 4 cm, it can bleed. And if there's a hemorrhage, we need to treat it by embolization. On angiography, it has onion peel or whorled appearance, like myoma in the fibroid. And on angiography, there might be some pseudoaneurysms, but there is no AV shunting or no AV fistula. So these are the important findings of renal angiomyolipoma.